Hello friends and welcome to my channel. This is Anat and today I will show you how to make fish cutlets. But before we get started, if you're new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel and please do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you get notified the next time I upload a new video. So let's get started. First, I have taken 4 mackerels. I have cleaned them well. Now we will take a pot, add the fish in it. Now we will add some salt and also some turmeric powder. We will mix them well so that the turmeric and the salt is applied well for the fish. Next we will add little water and we are going to keep it on the gas stove to boil for at least 15 to 20 minutes or till the fish is done. Now as you can see, they are almost done, so I'm just going to turn them. We are going to turn off the gas stove once they are done and we are going to allow them to cool. So now for the ingredients to cut, we will need a big size onion. You can also use 2 depending on the quantity of mackerels that you take. 1 tomato I have taken, 1 chili, and we will also need coriander. You will also require ginger garlic paste. Now if you don't have ginger garlic paste, you'll have to chop little ginger, chop little garlic and make paste and keep them ready. So now I will chop these and keep aside. So now as you can see, I have chopped these ingredients which were required to be cut. Along with these, you will also need 1 egg, you will need semolina, you will also need garam masala, haldi powder, vinegar and salt for taste if required. So now once the fish is cool, we are going to debone it. So see that you remove all the bones properly, otherwise it's going to be difficult for you to eat them. So see friends, I have deboned the fish. Now you just need to check once again if any bone is remaining. So now for the next step, we are going to keep a frying pan on the gas stove and we are going to add little oil into it. We are going to allow the oil to get little hot. So once the oil is hot, we are going to add our chopped onion into it. Saute this for some time. Let it turn little brownish or little transparent. So see friends, it's become a bit transparent. So now to this, we are going to add the tomato. Saute it well till the tomato is nice, soft and meshy. Now to this we are going to add 1 tablespoon ginger garlic paste. Mix it well. We will also add the chili. Now to this we are going to add little turmeric powder, a little garam masala, so now once this is done, we will add the fish. So there you go, we will add the fish now. mix it well. Now to this we are going to add the chopped coriander. Mix them well. Now lastly we are going to add 1 teaspoonful of vinegar. Mix all them well together again. And it's done, friends. We are going to turn off the gas stove now and we are going to allow this to cool now. So now once this mixture gets cool, we are going to add our egg into it. We are going to mix it well. So now for the next step, we will take little mixture, roll it and form it into a shape of a cutlet. See, you need to give it a nice shape. We are going to do like this one by one and we are going to keep ready. So you see, now this is done. Now for the next step. So now next step, we are going to keep a frying pan on the gas stove. Add little oil. Allow the oil to get little hot. So now my oil is hot. So now what we are going to do is, we are going to take one cutlet. Dip it in the semolina nicely. See? And we are going to place it in the frying pan. Similarly, I will do for all. We will add little more oil if required. We are going to allow them to fry for some time and after some time we are going to flip them. So now I will flip them. The one which I had put first, I will flip first. So see, friends, we will go on flipping all our cutlets. So see, friends, our cutlets are ready. Now I'm going to transfer them in the serving plate. So there you go, friends, our fish cutlets are ready. I hope your friends like the recipe. Please do try them and do let me know in the comment section how well you like the recipe. Till then, see you next time. Bye bye.